Friends, good morning. I am Mayur Patel. My subject is water management and micro irrigation. So today we are going to learn about topic is irrigation scheduling and method of irrigation. First, need a scheduling of irrigation before the selection of different method. And this is the process of selection of method by different way. Here, effective rainfall. Rainfall is the most important things in a irrigation to the proper way in the field. First, effective rainfall is the rainfall that is the available in the plant root and allowing the plant to the germinate or maintain its growth. This can be related to the rainfall various evaporation. When combined with the temperature figures, effective rainfall will indicate the main growing seasons for plants. As rules of the thumb, the evaporation from the exposed soil surface is about one-third that from the evaporimeter. Now, irrigation scheduling is most important things for the sowing of crop before the practices is the scheduling of irrigation. Irrigation scheduling is defined as the frequency with which water is to be applied based on need of the crop and nature of the soil. There is a very different type of soils available according to the soil type and nature of the soil. There is a different scheduling of irrigation. Irrigation scheduling is nothing but number of irrigation and their frequency required to the meet the crop water requirement. हम जो crop select कर रहे हैं तो वो crop की irrigation requirement कितनी है, वो crop के लिए कितना irrigation देना पड़ेगा, वो सब चीजें irrigation scheduling में आती है. और ये sowing किया तो sowing से पहले कितनी बार water देंगे और sowing किया तो उसके बाद से लेके harvesting तक कितना water उसको चाहिए वो पूरी सिस्टम इरिगेशन शेड्यूलिंग में आएगी. तो इरिगेशन शेड्यूलिंग में भी डिफाइंड एज अ साइंटिफिक मैनेजमेंट टेक्निक्स ऑफ अलाउइंग इरिगेशन वाटर बेस्ड ऑन द इंडिविजुअल क्रॉप वाटर रिक्वायरमेंट अंडर द डिफरेंट सोइल एंड क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशन विद द एम्स ऑफ अचीव मैक्सिमम क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन अंडर यूनिट अप्लाइड ओवर ए यूनिट एरिया इन द यूनिट टाइम. नाउ बेस्ड ऑन द अबाउट डेफिनेशन द कॉन्सेप्ट मेड इज इफ वी प्रोवाइड irrigation facility, the agriculture production and productivity will go up automatically, directly, and productivity is suddenly increased by sequentially. Irrigation scheduling is a decision-making process repeated many times in the each years, involving when the irrigation irrigate and the how much of water to be applied. These two things are most important in irrigation scheduling, when to irrigate and how much water to be applied for the field for a particular crop in a particular place according to the climatic condition. So the both criteria influencing the quantity and quality of the crops, it indicates how much of the irrigation water to be used as how often it has to be given. Now practical consideration in irrigation scheduling. Before irrigation scheduling, irrigation in the farms or field or a command, the following criteria should be taken care for the efficient and very useful irrigation scheduling. First one is a crop factor. It including very four type sensitiveness to the water shortage. Second thing is critical stage of the crop, rooting depth, economic value of the crop. These four are different way in cropping factor. It influencing is according to the crop system. Now second thing is water delivery system. How to deliver water from the one place to another place for our better crop production. So the first canal irrigation or tank irrigation, it is the public distribution systems where scheduling is arranged according based on the decision made by the public based on the resources availability. Well irrigation, individual decision is final. Here two type of irrigation system. First one is a public irrigation and second one is a personal irrigation system. In cases of public irrigation, canal, river and check dam, these all are a public irrigation system. By that way we are using the much more irrigation through the public irrigation and according to the irrigation availability. Now second thing is a personal irrigation things is a well or a borewell in our particular in our personal field area. So by that way we are using this water as like well water and as like a borewell water. By this way we are using and using in our crop production. Now third thing is type of soil. there is a different type of soils, but in cases of sandy and clay soils, sandy soils needs a short frequency of the irrigation and less quantity of water, because sandy soil absorb much more water and keep water long time. But in clay soil need long frequency of irrigation and more quantity of water, because clay particles is a very small particle, so the evaporation and transpiration is much more in clay soil, so it need a frequently irrigation and much more irrigation than the sandy soil. Now fourth thing is salinity hazard. To maintain the favorable soil balance, excess water application may be required rather than evapotranspiration requirement of the crop leach and the excess soil through the deep percolation, downward movement of the water into the soil. Now irrigation method, there is a different method which we are using for the better crop production. Basin method allows more infiltration through the more wetting surface, with the turn needs more water and log interval in irrigation frequency. Furrow method allows less infiltration due to the less wetting surface, which need less water and short interval in irrigation frequency. Now sprinkler system and drip irrigation is the most important, drip irrigation and sprinkler irrigation, for the irrigation to the particular field or a particular crop. By that way, sprinkler irrigation method needs less water and more frequency, it's cover more area and less less water requirement. In cases of drip irrigation, need to less water and more frequency. This work and in both these condition are same. It require a very less water, but it cover much more area. Irrigation interval, the extension of irrigation interval does not allow us save water. The interval has to be optimized based on the agroclimatic situation or a condition. Minimum spreadable depth is, we cannot reduce the depth based on the water requirement of the crop alone. The depth should be fixed based on the soil type, rooting nature of the crop, and irrigation method follows. The minimum depth should be so far the achieving uniformly and application to get the uniform distribution over the entire field. Now some theoretical approaches of irrigation scheduling, it including some four theoretical approaches. By that way, first one is direct approaches, depth interval and yield approaches, soil moisture and deficit and optimum moisture or regime approaches, sensitive crop approaches, plant observation method, indirect and predictive approaches, critical stage or a phenological stage approaches, meteorological and climatological approaches, and here containing mathematical approach, estimation of method approaches, simple calculation method, and fourth one is system as whole approaches, rotational and water supply scheduling. Here we will discuss about particularly step. Here first one is direct approaches, it includes the depth interval and yield approaches. In this method, different depth of irrigation water, different times interval fixed arbitrarily and the tired without considering the soil and water characteristics. It contains the disadvantage is rainfall is not taken into the account, groundwater contribution is not taken into account, soil parameters are not taken for the calculating irrigation requirement, and hence this approach is not in use. Second things is soil moisture deficit and optimum moisture regime approaches. These approaches considering the soil moisture content in the particular root zone of the soils of the crops for fixing the schedules. When the soil moisture reach as per fixed value, may be 40% of the available soil moisture or 50% of available moisture, 60% of available soil moisture, irrigation is given. The degree of depletion is measured through the percentage of availability by using the gravimetric, tensiometric, resistance block, nutrient probe and other systems. Now this contains the disadvantages is soil moisture alone is taken into the account, hence it cannot be taken for the all type of soil in particularly region. Is various from the soil to soil, different soil have a different soil moisture deficit or a optimum moisture regime condition. Now here some sensitive crop approaches. Some sensitive crop is useful when we are growing the main crop. According to the main crop, we have to grow some sensitive crop. By that way, we are able to achieve the goal of when to requirement of plant water. The crops which are growing for their fresh leaves or a fruit are more sensitive to the water shortage than the crop which are grown for their dry seeds or a fruit. Some here crop low sensitivity, low to medium sensitivity, medium to high sensitivity and high sensitivity crop are described here. Plant observation method, normally in field condition, farmer used to adopt these practices for the scheduling irrigation. This is a simple and all farmers are using this method. Basically, the day-to-day change in the plant physical characteristics like color of the plants, erect nature of the plants, leaves and wilting of plants, shoot status of plant, there is a different condition looking by the whole field area are closely and carefully observed on the all and not for the individual plant, and then time of irrigation is fixed according to the crop system. It need a more skill and experience because we are just observing field and then decide how the trace condition is observed in all our field. Now, predictive approaches of indirect approaches, critical stage of the phenological stage approaches. The growth period of an annual crop can be divided into four growth stage. This is the most important critical stage, crop development stage, mid-season stage and late season stage. First one is the initial stage from sowing to 10% ground, then after 10 to 70% ground cover, flowering to the grain setting and ripening stage and harvesting stage. So we have to keep mind these things to the, these four stages are most sensitive for the plant production. Meteorological approaches, the basis principles employing with the approaches are estimated of the daily potential evapotranspiration rate, hence it requires knowledge on the short-term evapotranspiration rate at a various stage of the plant development, soil water retention, permissible soil water deficit in the respect to the evaporative demands, effective routine depth of the crop grown. The irrigation scheduling is based on the cumulative pond evaporation. This is some irrigation water upon cumulative pond evaporation is equal to depth of water to be irrigation upon cumulative pond evaporation for the particular period. We can easily calculate irrigation water divided by the cumulative pond evaporation. Now, method of irrigation. There is a different method which we are using for the irrigation to our field. Water application methods are grouped as flooding, applying in it on the soil surface, spraying is under pressure like in drip irrigation, applying in drop is drip irrigation, pressure like a sprinkler system. Irrigation method is surface, subsurface, pasteurized irrigation system. First one is subsurface irrigation, border irrigation. The land is divided into number of long parallel strips called as a border. इसमें सिंपली बॉर्डर बनानी है जो लोकली हम यूज करते हैं. बॉर्डर बना के उसके अंदर प्लांट ग्रोइंग करना है, सोइंग करना है. दिस बॉर्डर आर सेपरेटली लो रीड्स, उसके रीड्स जो हम पाला बनाते हैं वो छोटा छोटा बनाना है. द बॉर्डर स्ट्रिप हैज यूनिफॉर्म जेंटली स्लोप इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इरीगेशन. जहां से हम पानी दे रहे हैं वो मेन चैनल से जहां पानी जा रहा है वो स्लोपी होना चाहिए, क्योंकि यहां से पानी दिया तो लास्ट तक पानी इजीली चला जाए. The water spread and flows down the strips in the seeds confined by the border reeds. Now, what is the suitability of border irrigation? Some here soil having a moderately low to moderate high infiltration rate. It is not used in coarse sandy soils that have very high infiltration rate, and also in heavy soils having a very low infiltration rate. Suitable to the irrigate all close growing crop like wheat, barley, fodder crop and legumes, and not suitable for rice crop. Now, some advantage: borderies can be constructed with the simple farm implement like bullock drones, a pumps, reeds or a burns farmer. Simply by that way we are easily constructed this border irrigation method. Large irrigation streams can be efficiently used. Now, second irrigation system is check basin irrigation system. It is the most common method. Here the field is divided into smaller unit area of the each has a nearly level surface. Chote chote check banana hai, choti choti border strip banani hai, to uske andar plant sowing karna hai aur crop growth karna hai. Bund or ridges are constructed around the area forming base within the which the irrigation water can be controlled. The size of the basin varies from the 10 meter square into 25 meter square depending upon soil types, topography, stream size and different crop which you are sowing. Now, adaptability. Small, gentle and uniform land slope, soil having a moderate to slow infiltration rate, adaptable grain to the fodder crop in the heavy soils, suitable to the permeable soil. Now, furrow irrigation system used in the irrigation of row crop. The furrow are formed between the crop row. The dimension of furrow depend on the crop grown, equipment used and soil types. Water is applied by small running streams in the furrow between the row crop. Water infiltrated into soil and spread laterally to the wet and area between the furrow system. In heavy soils, furrow can be used to dispose the excess water. Now here simply we can observe the furrow system. One furrow, then after reeds and furrow. By that way we are applying water, it's simply and much more water saving, and by that way we are also saving much more water than the furrow irrigation system. Alternate furrow system, एक रो में पानी देना है, दूसरी में नहीं देना है, एक रो में देना है, दूसरी में नहीं देना है. तो इस तरीके से हम वाटर अप्लाई करेंगे तो उससे क्या होगा, पूरी एक रो का जो पानी वेस्ट जा रहा है वो सेविंग कर सकेंगे, क्योंकि यहां जो रो में पानी देते हैं तो वो रो से दो साइड के क्रॉप को इजीली पानी मिल जाता है. तो दूसरी अल्टरनेट रो में पानी देने की जरूरत नहीं है. नहीं देंगे फिर भी सब प्लांट को इजीली पानी मिल जाएगा. इससे 50% वाटर हम सेविंग कर सकेंगे रीड्स एंड फरो सिस्टम में. Now adaptability, widespread row crop including the vegetables suitable for the maize, sorghum, sugarcane, cotton, tobacco, groundnut and potatoes like crops suitable to the most soil except sandy soils. Now some advantage, water in furrow contacts only on half to one fifth of the land surface. Labor requirement for the land preparation and the irrigation is reduced compared to the check basin. There is less wastage of land in field ditch. Now different type of furrow irrigation system based on the alignment of the furrow system, straight furrow system and contour furrow system, and second thing is based on the size and spacing, deep furrow system and corrugulation furrow system. Now based on the irrigation, all furrow irrigation water is applied evenly in all the furrow and are called as furrow system or uniform furrow system. Now alternate furrow system, as we discussed, it is not an irrigation layout but the technique for the water saving. Water is applied in the alternate furrow system. जैसे हमने यहाँ पे देखा कि alternate furrow system में पानी देना है, simply वो thing से हम पानी देंगे तो water saving ज्यादा होगा. Skip furrow irrigation, they are normally adapted during the period of the water scarcity and to the accommodate intercrop. तो पानी की sources हमारे पास कम है, पानी available ज्यादा नहीं है, तो क्या करेंगे, तो एक बार पानी दो, बाद में स्किप कर दो, दूसरी बार पानी दो, वैसे हम वाटर सेविंग स्किप फरो इरिगेशन में कर सकते हैं. सर्गे इरिगेशन इज द ऑन एंड ऑफ अप्लाइंग इरिगेशन वाटर इज नोन एज सर्गे इरिगेशन ऑफ द वाटर इन द फरो इंटरमीडिएटली इन द सीरीज ऑफ द रिलेटिव शॉर्ट ऑन एंड ऑफ टाइम ऑफ द इरिगेशन साइकिल. Now second thing is subsurface irrigation system. In subsurface irrigation, water is applied beneath the ground by the creating and maintaining an artificial water table at some depth, usually 30 to 75 centimeter below the ground surface. Now here we can easily see the water is applied through the underground field trench laid 15 to 30 meter apart. But in cases of our country, in cases of our region, it is not much more possible, or not farmer are adaptive, because this is a very costly things and sometimes it may be causes erosion or a soil deficit. Now advantage is minimum water requirement for the raising crop, minimum evaporation and deep percolation losses, because we are giving water deeply to 15 to 20 centimeter under ground. No wastage of land, no interferences of movement of farm machineries, cultivation operation can be carried out without concern of the irrigation period. Now some disadvantages like require a special combination of natural condition, there is a danger of the water logging condition, its most effect in this condition, possibility of the choking the pipes layer underground, high cost is a most different things, drip irrigation system is. We are understand very well about drip irrigation and sprinkler irrigation. We already discussed drip irrigation and sprinkler irrigation in first semester, so not need to know much more about drip irrigation and sprinkler irrigation. There is some component of drip irrigation, pump, chemical tanks, filter, emitters, and this is a whole structure of drip irrigation. By this way, by the well, easily water absorbed by the drip filters, and here sand separator filters is available by the sand filter, doing the filter of the sands and come out the water is clean water, then the sand filters is here also. By this way, main channel line, submental line and lateral line, and here some dripper are adopted, so by that way we are easily applying water to the particular drop wisely to the plant. Now some advantage of drip irrigation. We all are knowing about drip irrigation. Water saving much more, approximately 70 to 75% of water we are saving by the drip irrigation, suitable for the wide space row crop, particularly coconut and other horticulture trees crop. Soil erosion is reduced, better weed control, land saving, less labor cost. Now some disadvantage, high initial cost, because jo drip irrigation hum establishment karte hai hamare farm mein, तो शुरुआत में उसका कॉस्ट बढ़ जाता है, आफ्टरवर्ड उसमें कोई कॉस्ट दूसरा नहीं रहता है, क्योंकि हमको सिर्फ मेंटेनेंस करना पड़ता है, उसको ड्रिपर को साफ करना पड़ता है और पानी अच्छा पानी देना पड़ता है. बाय दैट वे वी कैन इजीली इरिगेट टू आवर फील्ड. ड्रिपर्स आर ससेप्टेबल टू द ब्लॉकेज, इंटरफियरेंस विद द फार्म ऑपरेशन एंड द मूवमेंट ऑफ इम्प्लीमेंट्स एंड द मशीनरीज, फ्रीक्वेंट मेंटेनेंस, ट्री ग्रोन में डेवलप शेलो कन्फाइंड रूट जोन एंड रिजल्टिंग इन पुअर एंड एनक्रोज. Now some layout of sprinkler irrigation system. We already know about sprinkler irrigation. Also we called overhead or a pressure irrigation systems. And by this irrigation system is prepared by aluminum or a PVC pipe. This is the some figures about drip irrigation system. By that way the whole area covered by simply irrigation. Now sprinkler system usually consists of the following parts. There is different part which are considering in the drip irrigation system: pumping unit, pipeline, couplers, sprinklers, other accessories, fittings like water meters, pressure gauge, bent trees, reduced elbows, hydrants, buffalo fly valve and plug and risers, debris removes equipments and fertilizer application. Application of fertilizer with the water is known as a fertigation. By that way drip irrigation and sprinkler irrigation we can easily fertigation give. Type of sprinkler system on the basis of arrangement for the spraying irrigation water, rotating heads or the revolving sprinkler system, profitable pipe systems. Based on the profitability, portable systems, semi-portable system and semi-permanent system. In cases of portable system, it has a portable main line and lateral line at the portable pumping unit. In cases of semi-portable system, a semi-portable system is similar to the fully portable system, except the location of the water sources and pumping plant are fixed. In cases of semi permanent system, it's considering a semi permanent system as a portable lateral lines, permanent main line and sub main line also. Now solid set system, a solid set system has the enough lateral to the eliminate their movement. Permanent system, it consists of the permanently laid main, sub main and lateral and the stationary water sources and the pumping plant. Now some advantage of this based on the portability. Now water saving to the extent to 35 to 40%, saving in the fertilizers, suitable for the undulating topographic, suitable for the porous texture, forest control, drainage control, saving in land, fertilizer and other chemicals can be easily we are applying with the water. Disadvantage, high initial cost, we all are knowing. Efficient is affected by the wind, higher evaporation, because sprinkler irrigation is sprinkling in the atmospheric condition, so the evaporation loss is higher in sprinkler system. Not suitable for tall crop like sugarcane, not suitable for the heavy clay soils. Poor quality water cannot be used because sensitivity of the crop to the saline water and the clogging of the nozzles. Now some step to be taken for the reducing the salt deposit on the leaves and fruit during the sprinkler irrigation. First one is irrigate at a night, because controlling of evaporation, increase the spares of the sprinkler rotation, decrease the frequency of irrigation. Now some irrigation efficiency, some formula by that way irrigation efficiency calculate, WC upon WR into 100s. Water use efficiency we can calculate, WU upon WD into 100s. Now water use efficiency is categorized by two ways: crop water use efficiency and field water efficiency. Crop water use efficiency is yield upon evapotranspiration. Now crop water use efficiency is also calculated by the water yield upon G plus E plus T, and different ways Y upon cumulative evaporation. Field water use efficiency is calculated by yield upon WR, water requirement. Now conjunctive use of water. Conjunctive use has been defined in the more way than one, but in the general it is defined as the allocation of surface water and groundwater in terms to quantity and quality, so as to achieve one or more objective while satisfying certain constraints. So the conjunctive use of water has to also been defined with reference to the stream's diversion or run of the river systems as the management of groundwater, surface water in coordinate operation of the end that can total all the systems over the period of years, excess the sum of yield of the separate components of the system resulting from the uncoordinated operation. This is the some reference which we are using for the much more understanding. Thank you. Thank you very much.